Hey everyone, my name is Josh, and I'm a global product lead on Google App Campaigns. With the introduction of new platform policies, iOS measurement has become more complex, and multiple measurement frameworks have emerged. In this video, we will break down key Google-supported iOS measurement frameworks, explain notable core differences between them, and lastly, provide our recommended guidance for when to use each for measuring Google iOS App Campaigns. So let's dive in. Two key iOS measurement frameworks exist which Google currently supports: Google's conversion modeling and Apple's SKAdNetwork, also known as SKAN. Google's conversion modeling is reported in the Google Ads interface and uses Google AI to assess event-level performance of your campaigns when a subset of conversions cannot be directly linked to ad interactions. Over the last 2 years, we've continued to improve our conversion modeling using SKAN data. And additionally, as of November 2024, we have launched back-end model quality enhancements to make our reporting in Google Ads stronger and more actionable. On the other hand, Apple's SKAdNetwork tool measures your app installs and in-app activity on an aggregated basis and has become important for some advertisers in assessing campaign performance across multiple ad networks. While both frameworks provide valuable data, they have distinct and defining characteristics. Because of these underlying differences, some level of reporting discrepancies between the two is normal and expected. The first primary source for discrepancies can be attributed to conversion windows. SKAN version 3 uses shorter 24-hour conversion windows to assess post-install conversions. On the other hand, with Google's conversion modeling, you can set post-install conversion windows anywhere between 1 to 90 days after the install, allowing you to observe post-install activity over a longer time frame that might be more representative of your app's user journey. The second common source of discrepancy is web-to-app conversion measurement for non-Safari browsers. SKAN updates have improved SKAN observability of web-to-app conversions only on Safari browsers. However, it's important to note that there may still be small measurement gaps from other mobile browsers, such as Chrome or Firefox, which are still unsupported by SKAN. Google conversion modeling is representative across all search touchpoints for your campaigns. Lastly, a third and final discrepancy source can be the differences between how each framework defines a re-download. So how do you choose which measurement framework to use? Today, we support Google conversion modeling and SKAN, and we recommend to advertisers to understand how to think about each tool when making a business decision. SKAN can enable a big picture view of how your campaigns perform across numerous ad networks. It's well suited to use for long-term decisions like planning your overall ad budget across partners. Since SKAN reports do take time to process, given conversion windows, timers, and other variables, we recommend checking them about once every 30 days. That means that SKAN reports are less useful for real-time, granular insights and optimizations on a daily or weekly basis. Conversion modeling might be more similar to the traditional reporting that you might be used to. Conversion modeling provides a more detailed view of campaign performance to help you make more informed optimization decisions, like which ad creatives are working best. One of the key benefits for conversion modeling is to use it when SKAN reporting data isn't available, especially to track what users do after they install your app. In short, if you're looking for reporting that is more indicative of the full value of a user across your app's conversion window, you might want to lean towards Google conversion modeling to supplement your understanding of performance. Lastly, it is important to remember that conversion delay does still apply in Google conversion modeling. We continue to recommend that customers wait the full length of the conversion window before assessing campaign performance. So what's the best approach? Our most successful advertisers typically find ways to use both measurement frameworks. Many successful advertisers use SKAN for long-term planning and conversion modeling for daily optimization. We've covered a lot, and it's important that we do recognize the highly dynamic nature of the iOS landscape. For example, at WWDC in 2024, Apple announced Ad Attribution Kit, or AAK, a measurement framework that builds upon the core principles of SKAN. Google does not currently support AAK for attribution at this time, but we are actively reviewing Apple's documentation and will notify customers if and when there is more information to share. In the meantime, We continue to support SKAN as a measurement option available to you. To wrap up, we believe both conversion modeling and SKAN have unique benefits for iOS measurement. However, as we discussed, you should understand their distinct characteristics and determine how to best use these tools for your unique business decisions. For a deeper dive into SKAN, check out our other videos on configuring your SKAN conversion value schema for post-install measurement and evaluating your iOS SKAN report. You can also find more resources in the description below.